In our fast-moving world, change is the only constant. Things are evolving at a rapid pace, influencing the needs and expectations of humanity from every corner of the world. One charity group has constantly kept pace with these changes, transforming itself as the social arm of the Catholic Church to an economic game changer, putting income in the pockets of women, youth, and most vulnerable in the society. That group is the Caritas, the Socio-Economic Development Commission of the Catholic Diocese of Machakos in the Bishop's office. Caritas Machakos is synonymous with integrity, enterprise, and nation building. Through social engineering, the organization facilitates resource mobilization and implementation of community development and relief projects with love of God for humanity. It expresses charity, compassion, cooperation, and peace among God's people. Drawing its inspiration from the Holy Scriptures and the social teachings of the Church, Caritas Machakos enhances capability of the poor and marginalized communities to live just and decent lives.
Our target has been to empower smallholder farmers. 11,000 smallholder farmers we have empowered for the last 5 years within the program. Where we are focusing on transforming the smallholder farmers from subsistence farming to farming as a business, where we are focusing on generating incomes.
Caritas Machakos facilitates implementation and promotion of food security projects, access to clean water, environmental conservation, capacity building for quality leadership, and relief in times of natural calamities like drought, floods, and others. In 2013, Dry Land Development Program conducted a baseline survey to identify value chains sustainable in dry lands of Makueni, Kitui, and Machakos in Kenya.
Caritas comes in to work for the Drylands Development Program in Makueni, where we are doing several projects in relation to agriculture, and we want to ensure that our farmers move from subsistence farming, where they depend on relief food, to farming where they have food on their table, they have food security, and also they have something left to sell in the market.
Later in 2014, through community action plans, farmers in Makueni settled for goat rearing as one of their value chain product, and Rylands Development Program commissioned Caritas Machakos to implement the local goat breed improvement program.
Farmers preferred to keep goats as opposed to other value chains like mango growing. So it was such a bottom-up approach from the community.
In the livestock improvement activity, where we are focusing on the goats, we went and did an assessment with the community. We went to the households. In fact, those households were poor, vulnerable. Children barely not going to school. Food on the table is a problem. A household mainly relying on remittances from their husbands who are working in the towns. Remittances on a monthly basis, that is not enough to cater for the family needs.
Caritas Machakos has grown in its enterprising techniques to giving a community a sustainable alternative source of income while conserving the environment. The Gala goat.
We realize that our goats are resistant to diseases. They withstand the high temperatures that are within our area. They are also very resistant to long distances in terms of going to drink water. But they are very small. They don't have a lot of milk.
The key motivator was just to improve on their local breeds of the goat. And according to the project, options by contest, which appeared on the cap, showed that the goat can do well here in Katakan.
So to improve on this, we have imported Gala goats from our neighboring counties so that we can improve on the goats to produce more milk and to produce more meat.
The region being arid, poverty levels were hitting highs of 67%, with families having no alternative sources of income. It was a window of hope for Benedin Mwikali, a member of the group who has since been rearing fewer goats but getting more benefits.
Napata our tumi chakula kingi ni kama mbuzi wa kawaida wenye tuko nao kwa sababu wakati mvua imenyesha ile nyasi ambayo inamea na yale matawi ambayo yanapatikana unapata hao mbuzi wanakula tu chakula kidogo wanashimba.
The little rain we get around here easily helps to generate forage and also grass. We saw it is in order. If farmers keep goats, they will be able to utilize now the forage, the grasses which come as a result of the little rain we receive here.
Improvement of locally adapted yet less productive goat breeds gives farmers a chance to quickly and flexibly match the available genetic resources to the existing reproduction environment without using extra resources.
The major problem we were solving by advising Caritas to bring those galas here, one of them is inferior, low producing goat breeds. By bringing gala goats, being a superior breed.
We are doing this by supporting them with the gala goats or the gala buck to enable them breed, have a better breed with the local breeds that they have.
Wanachukua muda kidogo wale mbuzi ku breed. Sababu unapata after 6 months wale mbuzi unaweza pata wamepata watoto. Alafu ukifuatilia maziwa yao yako kiwango cha juu kidogo ukikombea na wale wengine wa kawaida ambao tumekuwa tukifuza. Na kwa muda kidogo kama miezi mitano sita hivi unapata yule mbuzi unaweza mpeleka sokoni na upate mapato ya juu.
Wakati nilipewa hiyo mbuzi ya ngarangauti, nilifurahi kwa sababu ilinigeuzia mbuzi zangu, zimezaa, siko na watoto wanane, watoto wanakuwa haraka. Niliuza mbili, moja inakitoka 1,500, nikapeleka school fees, nikalipia mtoto.
Gala goats are tantamount to high reproduction rate, fast growth, high milk yields, and feeds on wide range of forages within a small area, giving the farmer a chance to keep few goats while fetching more income than their East African counterparts.
They can breed very fast because of the high twinning rates that they have.
Most of the farmers are reporting the goats are doing double kidding. Also, they triplets.
They breed faster, they give birth like twice a year, and most of the goats that breed with gala goats give birth to twins or triplets, hence ensuring that farmers can have many goats at maybe in 1 year. They can have more goats, unlike when they have their local breeds. And also their weight gives them an advantage of having to sell a large amount of meat and fetching more money.
In partnership with Kenya's Government Ministry of Livestock, Caritas trained the farmers on breeding and breed selection, disease control, among other good animal husbandry techniques. Farmers have for long been inbreeding the East African goat breed, and this has resulted in smaller sized goats that fetch low market prices. Moreover, the goats are smaller in size, have slow growth rate, and are known to increasing soil erosion as their hooves loosen the soil crust while they hoover foraging.
Without the intervention of government projects, farmers themselves had made the initiative of trying to change their breeds by buying goats they perceived were galas from across the river, that is Kitui district.
A good gala buck for breeding is white in color, has a long neck, long ears, well-spaced front legs, evenly divided testicles, and a good body frame. The Gala goats are tall and have a long body, which houses more meat, reaching an average weight of 70 kilograms, hence fetching a good cash at the marketplace. They are adapted to arid and semi-arid areas and browse on different types of vegetation with high feed conversion rate, hence can forage within a small area.
As we know, Gala goats, they feed on all types of forage, including the grass and the leaves, unlike the local breeds that concentrate on the leaves, and so there is less destruction to the trees. And also, being few means they are less destructive to the environment, which is also what we are encouraging as breeders. And it also means that the farmer can still have the same benefits with like 5 goats, the same as having 15 local goats.
This has proved to be a defining moment for climate change initiatives, as it has marked out diversification into Gala goat to local breed upgrading, which results into a more disease-tolerant, improved first-generation breed. The Kenya government livestock expert frequents the farmers in endeavors to exchange ideas and do routine checks of the animals. The group continues to be a significant component in Gala goat breeding project and a staging point for business opportunities utilizing the rather harsh dry climate in rearing more profitable goats. Recognizing the region's economic ability on sustainable growth path, members are on fast foot forward to tap the potential in maximizing Gala goat reproduction.
Kama kikundi, tumekuwa na mpango kwa miaka mitano ijayo kila mtu aongeze idadi ya wale mbuzi yako nao na wale wataweza kuzaliwa pale wale wa kike tuweze kuwakuza kwa wingi ndipoza tuweze kupata wengi kwa muda kwa wakati ujao kwa sababu tumeona tukiwa na wengi tunaweza kuuza as a group na kukiuza pamoja ile tunaita collective marketing ndio tunaweza pata mapato mengi na pia tuko na mpango wakati hao mbuzi wetu wamepata watoto tunaweza kuuza maziwa kwa pamoja na vile tunaona bei ya maziwa ya mbuzi iko juu kulinga tukikombea na hao mbuzi wengine wa kawaida hao mbuzi wanatupea maziwa mengi na pia wanakuwa haraka unapata kwa baada ya mwaka moja tunaweza kuwa na mbuzi wengi tunaweza kuuza na ni mbuzi wa dhamana mbuzi ambaye ako ni mkubwa ukikombea na wale wa kawaida.
Kasweka mwavuli farmers with Gala bucks share them with neighbors intentionally to minimize inbreeding, which results to a weaker offspring vulnerable to diseases. They keep records whenever such happens and are tracking a genotype sequence plan to face out the inbreeding menace.
Kwa wakati ujao, utapata hii area yetu ya Kathekani, tumeimprove na tumesonga mbele. Kwa sababu wale mbuzi sio sisi tunatumia peke yetu kwa kikundi chetu pia tunapea majirani na mbuzi wao wameendelea kuchange wakaendelea kupata mbuzi ambao wana mapato ya juu na mbuzi wakubwa.
Farmers, experts and support team have unanimously read on the same line, the line of hope and success of a program which seemed like a mirage in a desert of poverty and hopelessness.
Mimi binafsi nimesaidika kwa sababu nilikuwa na mbuzi wachache na hao mbuzi wale ambao nimeweza kupata kutokana na hao mbuzi wa kiume tulipewa wa Gala goats nimeona wakiwa wa kunisaidia kwa sababu wakati kama huu sina shida ya fedha ya kununulia watoto chakula, sina shida ya kulipia watoto wangu karo na pia sikosi pesa. Kwa hivyo maisha yangu naona nimeimprove kwa maisha yangu.
Over that short period, we have realized change. Change that is our guide to this new and exciting future. change that inspires us and challenges us to be the best we can be.
As the officer for DryDev, I can really say that it was a good journey. We started small, but the fruits we have today and the stories that we have today, and also what we can see from the farmers, is that the Gala bags are really doing well. So far, so good. We have over 50 offsprings in a span of 1.5 years from the Gala bags.
As Caritas, we serve our main purpose, which reflects the church responsibility to God, our stakeholders, employees, society, and the environment, ensuring lasting sustainability as we are poised for strategic expansion. The Gala Goat is a game changer. It encompasses the Caritas' renewed vision, inspired by our values of love of God for humanity, expressed through charity, compassion, cooperation, and peace among God's people.
Since we introduced the Gala Goats and improved on the existing goats that they had, the goats are kidding twice a year. They grow very fast. They put on weight. In 8 months, you can take the kid to the local market, which will not fetch less than 9,000. That is great improvement. The women are very happy. The households have improved. Children are accessing school. And that's the success of Caritas. The success of the program. We are truly changing lives.
As we continue to grow and shape the future, our team incorporates dialogue and table meetings. This helps create synergy and clear sight across the organization's regional inventiveness, allowing us to operate more seamlessly, proactively, and cost-efficiently.